Hallelujah. Well, family, greetings. It's such a beautiful, you know, thing for us to meet in this fashion. Just, you know, enjoy each other's company in the presence of the Lord. I'm going to share a word, and then we're going to receive communion, and then I'm going to give way so that we may just enjoy each other as we enjoy the meal. John chapter 15, I'm going to read a couple of verses from verse 5. John chapter 15 from verse 5, amen. It says, I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. Now, these are the words of Jesus. And this statement is a very powerful statement that you can only ignore at your own peril. Uthi Yesu, apart from me, ngaphandle kwam, ithi, you can do nothing. So what does this mean? This means that the only time nothing is possible is when you are apart from God. Can I say it again? The only time it's possible to do nothing, it's when you are apart from God. So, you work all day, late, I am tired. What have you done? Nothing. In other words, all my efforts amounted to nothing. So, the only time it is possible to do nothing is when you are apart from God. With God, nothing shall be impossible. In other words, you can't be with God and work and work and at the end of the day and say, I've done nothing. Because with God, nothing is impossible. Let me say it differently. With God, all things are possible. So, the worst thing you can do to yourself, therefore, is to live your life apart from Jesus. That's the worst thing you can do to yourself. That was John 15, verse 5. Now, verse 6, uti, if anyone abides in me, rather, if anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away like a branch and withers. Now, the picture and denial, yale verse, he picture ye biltong. If au connectanga kuye, I process yako, if I ne process yokwenzo kwe biltong. You dry up. You lose all the juice and all the sap and all the life, and then you are dry. Now, in conclusion, E.T., what is this good for? He answered, E.T., look, at least we can still use it to make fire. This is Jesus saying, verse 6, if anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away like a branch and withers. So, withering is a drying process. Withering does not take place instantly and immediately. It takes place gradually. Withering is a gradual process. If I now almost, how care spinach, see fresh. But we know from that moment, life is leading, is living it. The only process that will take place is withering. It's losing all the life with time. That's what we mean by withering. Amen. So that's what happens to a Christian who's not abiding. Because Jesus is the life-giving sap. You see, he's the vine. We are the branches. So we get the sap from the vine. We live by connection. And then he says, if you abide in me, verse 7, and my words abide in you. So he's teaching us now how to abide in him. You abide in him by seeking his word, by searching his word, by reading his word. If you abide in me and my word in you, ask whatever you wish, it will be done for you. Why? Because you know the will of the Father, you can ask according to the will of the Father. Verse 8. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit. There are many dimensions of fruit. There's a fruit of the mind is called ideas. There's a fruit of the womb is called children. There's the fruit of your hands is called work. There's the fruit of a believer, which is, there are fruits of the spirit, you know, self-control, and all those things. There's a fruit of a believer called another believer. There's a fruit of a disciple called another disciple. Verse 9, this is where I begin. As my Father has loved me, so have I loved you. And now, listen to this part. Abide in my love. Abide in my love. Don't just know that you are loved. Settle there. Settle there. Settle on the truth that you are loved. Cherish the truth. Embrace it. Walk in it. Beloved, I said it yesterday. I can't say it enough. You have to be persuaded and convinced that you are loved by God. It will revolutionize your life. Just knowing. You see, there are many people that live their life with the belief that they are hated. And that changes their lives. Because they have this belief that I am not loved. I am hated. And it affects their life negatively. I want to challenge you to believe. Remember, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that whosoever believes. How do you embrace the love of God? By believing. You have to believe. You don't have to feel it. You will feel it later. If you feeling, because I feel a bambi, skalange love. Because feelings are not reliable. I have feelings for you. Till when? Who's next? It's me now. Who's next? Jesus is not saying abide in your feelings for me. No. Abide in the truth that I love you. I mean, Jesus loved us when he was in pain. He loved us. Remember, you think about the one you love. When he was on the cross, he said, Father, forgive them. In pain. That's how deep his love was. So, you are loved by God. And you are loved deeply by God. You have to believe that truth. So, uthu Yesu, ndicela ke ustake, sudlula kule ndawo yoba uyathandwa nguThixo. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love. How do you abide in the love? You keep the commandments of God. Now listen to this. This is very important. But we can miss it. Because what made Jesus to butt heads with the Pharisees is this. The Pharisees kept the law of Moses. But they also wanted people to keep their interpretation of the law of Moses. For example, Moses says, honor the Sabbath. Keep the Sabbath. And then the Pharisees would add and say, on a Sabbath, don't walk more than a quarter of a mile. More than a quarter of a mile, you have worked. The Pharisees would say, if you have made a fire, let's say we are pick up. If ulayitile la mlilo usebenzile, but if you have an unbeliever, you know, fixing the fire for you, then it's okay because it's an unbeliever. Does that make sense? So what the Pharisees did, they took the law and they brought their interpretation of the law, which was not bad. But what they did is they elevated the interpretation to the same level of the law. That's why they had a problem with Jesus. Jesus believed in the Sabbath, but Jesus understood that the Sabbath was for man, not the man for Sabbath. God made the Sabbath for man, not man for the Sabbath. That's why when they were hungry, Jesus allowed them to go and pluck some food to eat. When a man was sick, he instructed him, take your bed. That's why if your cow falls in a ditch on a Sabbath day, are you going to wait until tomorrow? Because Sabbath is made for man, not man for Sabbath. So the problem with the Pharisees, they had the heart to keep the commandments, but their interpretation, they wanted to canonize their own interpretation and bring it to the level of the word. So what am I saying? Jesus is saying, this is Jesus, this is not Moses. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. Beloved, we have commandments. Love one another is a commandment. Love the Lord is a commandment. Now, as soon as interpretation is it, we love by hugging. We love. So tata interpretation we end umthetho. But love. So let's express our love. We need to discover what is God saying is love. All of God's interpretation of love includes these words, sacrifice, losing, dying. If you're going to love those words, I have like interpretation. Because our sense of love is, No. Love means, for example, a parent that loves their child. Uva kuthiwa umntana uhleli kwi drug den ethile pa bapha. Aphuma umama. Ayongena pa. Akayena bakuzothwani. Unento ethi bakuyafiwa nza ufa kodwa ke lo ndimthandayo upha. I will go in makafo fire avuko vukayo, but I love the one is there. You see, love is sacrificial. Love is not self-preserving. So Jesus demonstrated that by dying for us. But I'm not even talking about that now. As my Father, so by this my Father is glorified that you bear much fruit. Where are we? Okay. If you keep my commandments, verse 10. If you keep my commandments. So the question is, what are the commandments of Jesus? Love the Lord with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your strength. And the second is love your neighbor as you love yourself. Those are commandments. And then he extended it. We must love our enemies. Those are commandments. And he commissioned us, go and make disciples. He has commanded us. Listen to this. If you keep my commandments, you'll abide in my love. So, you don't love Jesus by calling him my love. Say, Jesus, my love. You know,
No, no, you don't love Jesus by calling him a love. He told us how he wants to be loved.
He says, just as I kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. So you will see that here, the commandments of Jesus are not legalistic in nature. They are freedom-giving commandments. He says, these things I've spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy might be full. Now, he's very explicit, verse 12. Let's turn to verse 12. This is my commandment. I was a pep.
So, uti, utini, utini, yesu ndia mva, uti, uyanutandu tata, utatu ya mtanda, natu ya standa, nati masimtande, utini.
This one is my commandment. That you love one another.
Do you know that? You can love a person you don't like. That's why he did not say that you like one another. Liking is something else. He said love. He didn't say like. How many people have you said to someone you love, I hate you? But this person you love. But you say, I hate you. You saying I hate you does not change the fact that you love them. In fact, you hate them for the very reason you love them. What you're actually saying is that at this moment, I don't like you at all. At this moment, I don't like you. I love you, but I don't like you at all. Get out of my sight. Keep quiet. Don't say anything. I don't like you. Now, Jesus did not say like one another. He said love. Do you know why? Because love is a decision. Love is a choice you make. You can choose to love the other person today. But mfundisi, beve gobani kuthiwa bona bebenhleba. Gokunti nami kaloku andizokwazi kaloku. No, uzawukwazi. No, seriously, uzawukwazi. The Bible expects you to ukwazi. Yes. Let me tell you the truth, beloved. All of us have our seasons of not being likable. Can you imagine if it was dependent on likability? All of us would have lost each other by now if it depended on likability. Because that's why yesterday people showed me a face when I said, before you fall in love, love. Because falling in love is the liking dimension. You fall in love, you like. But in the same way you fell in love, you're going to fall out of love. So whilst you're busy falling in and out, keep loving. Yeah, even? Because the likability fluctuates. Kwa wena nje unesizwe ungabi likeable. Unesizwe onameva ngazo, uyahlaba some seasons. Sikhona siyafuna uhaga qa. Yo, kunzima. Uthi umjoli qona ba, hayi tabulisa ngomso. Today is not the right time. Otherwise, lento ndiyafuna uyadressa but not today. Nothing has changed. I still love, but the likability levels have dropped. Beyond likability, when you busy, you like a pulpan in 20. Yo, nanko, I can send her energy. I can say fresh. Yo, and call up or two. And call ready for to also buzz. Around me. You energy and gaga. Gomba, would you come to chair them all? Gomba, you get a shop on a plan and come. Yo, and deny it to the energy. As I'm born, but we are born. Today is not the day. So there are moments when even the other person is likable, but you're not in a mood to like. So Jesus did not hinge this truth on our feelings. Uyibeke kwi conviction. Uyibeke kwi 11 ye conviction. Xa kuthiwa umuntu yi convict, thethe uthwane. Yi convict libanjwa. So xa u convicted inyani uba libanjwa lalo nyani. Ibanjwa lexesha lovuka, nexesha lolala, nexesha loyotya. Let's say you're a male lang. No, but I'll be willing to go to our later to go with our young. But our young will post with the lang. Because our young. So that's what the conviction of truth does to you. You don't feel like it. You are a convict of truth. That's why Jesus placed this truth at the level of conviction. Not at the level of convenience. So, ndiyacela ke bazalwane ukuba singene lento yothando. Ndiyayazi kunzima, kunzima ecaweni, kunzima kakhulu ecaweni ezanto zithi uyoyika nothu umntwini uyamthanda. Hleze kulindelwe lobola, bungamishi lonto wena buciba, ndisabe ukuthi I'm a brother. I love you, my sister. Kunzima, oh, you can't say those words. Yeah? So, ngokufuna kube indlela. Namacebo ombonisa ba, right with you. Okay, kuyanetha man. Awufuni ndifuna kube indlela. Awukwazi wakhupha amazwi. Like uYesu uthi, my father loved me, I loved you. Oh, yo, anawukwazi uthi, I love you. Kubi phandla apho. That makes sense. But the point is, we need to find it in our hearts to go beyond the feeling and express genuine love for one another. And I'm telling you now, love is expressed in care. Love is expressed in attention. You can't say, we are husband, there's no attention. The secret of love is attention. You pay attention. Now, when the chili is all, go, kaya, wow, kaluba sema tandweni, wow, take a time 5 rand, ipele, we open to load 5 rand, ipele, ute, uboleka, no boleka, when the advance, ufunu kibesa la lengoko, why? Because love demands attention. That's why umdom tanda, yo onga kfone langu kumba. Tonga fona, I been getting a time. Tonga please call. Why? Because love demands attention. So when you love a person, attend to them. That's what Jesus did. He attended to our situation. I'm almost done. So he says, this is my commandment. That you love, not ababe click yako, not ababa kwi level yako, not ababa kwi category yako, not ababa ufil shaba amongst them I'm in my element. No. It's an indiscriminate love. Indiscriminate love. Love one another. Love one. And it's a commandment. Now, if it's a commandment, it means it can be done. The Bible says the commandments of the Lord are not burdensome. If uyesu uti tandanan, akabuzwa, how do you feel about this business of loving each other? Yo, yesu, yazi mna yesu, tali nyani mna yesu, mna umo wamdi umdo tanda ayo. Kayo, I understand yesu, baya dika abantu. Abantu becawa zi hypocrites. Batheta le benze le. Otherwise mna yesu ndi umdo tanda. That God man is pume kubo. Because abana nyani. Abantu becawa abana straight. They will give you promises. Abantu becawa ukiba kwabo benze nyinto. Otherwise mna ndi atanda yesu. I promise you. I am a loving person, Jesus. I'm a loving person. So unto Yesu, it's a commandment. Abana nyani ne? Batande. Batande, bate, banyani seke, batande. That's why I command his coupe. So, okay. Batande. So, this business of loving one another is commanded. We are commanded it. Why? Because we can do it.